Hello and welcome to the knowledge transfer session on data scraping. This is from PERSEC Research and my name is Ranvijay Krishna. I work as a data analyst at PERSEC Research. Without wasting time, let's move on to the first slide and understand what data scraping is. On this very slide, you can see the three definitions which I have extracted from internet, of course. The first definition says that data scraping is a technique which helps to extract structured data from any web page or any application and save it to a database or spreadsheet or a CSV file. Now the second definition says that scraping is commonly defined as a system where a technology extracts from a particular code base or a program. Data scraping provides results for a variety of uses and automates aspect of data aggregation. Now the third definition that says that data scraping in its most general form refers to the technique in which a computer program extracts data from output generated from another program. Data scraping is commonly manifest in web scraping, the process of using an application to extract valuable information from a website. Now after reading all these three definitions, it should have been clear what data scraping means, but in case if it is not clear, then you can compare data scraping to reading book and taking notes. Just like when you read a book, you take notes. You take notes of something which is important to you or which have some meaning for you. Similarly, in data scraping, you always scrap the pages for relevant information. Let me give you an example to make it more clear that if you want the product information from an online e-commerce site such as Flipkart, what you can do is you can use the data scraping tools available for free and paid also, and then you can use those tools to get the product information about the product which you want, and then you can use it for your analysis and reporting purpose. So this is what is data scraping is in its very layman terms, that it helps in extracting the relevant information which is necessary for you, which is necessary for the analysis and which has some meaning. So now moving on to our next slide, which is why do we use it. So this slide talks about what is the need and why should we use it. So let me tell you that the information which is referred to as data is very costly outside, and you cannot have a direct access to information on the web pages. For example, if we want to extract product information from online e-commerce site like Amazon or Walmart or Flipkart, you cannot directly download it in your Excel file because there is no option for it. Either you copy paste it or you can use data scraping, because as it has been already defined that scraping gives you the power to extract the important information or the information which is relevant to you without spending too much time on the system or with less effort. So that is the main reason why we use scraping. Now moving on to our next slide, but how does it work? The working of this entire procedure of scraping is quite complex, but on the surface it can be looked by these icons and this flowchart available on the screen. The first is a system on which the scraping tool is running. Now the scraping tool sends a request to the site's server. The site server, if accepts the request, will give you the permission to scrap that website. Or if it does not give you the permission, then you cannot scrap that website. So the tools which are available for scraping I have divided this particular slide into two categories, that the tools which are available for people who know coding and the tools which are available for people who do not know coding. So for the people who know how to code, there are two platforms, two languages which are most widely used today. That is Python and R. Within Python, you have several libraries like Selenium, Spider, Scrappy, Beautiful Soup, Request, and many more. And in R, you have HTML, XML, and RVest. But if you are from a non-coding background, then you can go for the third-party tool or a GUI graphical user interface based applications such as Parser, OctoParser, UI Studio, Excel, and many more. The tools which I use while I do my web scrapping projects, so these are Parser, OctoParser, UI Studio, and RVest. Out of this, I personally prefer Parser, and you will get to know why in the upcoming slides. So let's move on to the next slide. Now, Parser, my personal favorite, because it is a GUI based data scraper with a power to scrap almost all websites. It is an application which is free of cost to download from their website, that is www.parser.com. You can get it for free. You can sign in or sign up, and then you'll be able to use their software. It is especially designed with a motive to make scrapping easy for those who do not know how to code or maybe too lazy to code. The interface is easy to grasp and comes with a tutorial to help you with understanding it. As we know that with power comes responsibility, so does with free software comes a limitation. The free version is limited to 4 projects at a time, with each having their limit to scrap 200 pages in a single run. So this is an overview about the Parser. In the next slide, you will get to see the interface of Parser, that how does it looks like. This is the interface of Parser. That is when you open the software, this is the screen which you will see. You have a new project option, you have runs option, you have my account option, you have integration option, you have plans and billing option, you have tutorials, you have documentation, you have APIs, and many more. Moving on to our next slide. This is a Walmart project which I did on Parser. As you can see on the left hand side, the blue and the gray tiles are all the set flow, or you can say the workflow of how this tool will scrap the information which I want. In my case, I wanted the product detail, their price, their reviews, and their delivery time. So there were 4 requirements from my side which I scrapped using this Parser tool. So after completing the entire project, the output which I got was like this. As you can see, a snapshot on my screen of the Excel file, it gave me around 7975 records in less than 15 minutes. Now if you were to copy and paste all of these, then you would have taken a day or so, I guess, or maybe like hour or 4 hours, maybe a couple of hours. But with this tool, this entire work was completed in less than 15 minutes. Now in the next slide, I will walk you through about how the project was done. But before that, what are the benefits of using it? It helps you set the flow of extraction, and then all you need to do is click on get data, and it will keep on extracting until its limit is reached. That is the 200 pages can be scrapped in one go for the free version. Even if it shut down or suddenly disappear from the screen, it will continue to run in the background, and once completed, an email notification will be sent to you. So if sometimes what happens due to overloading, it just shuts down for some reason, but it actually not shuts down, it is running in the background. The entire extraction process is running in the background, and once it is completed, it will send you an email ID, the very same email ID which you used to sign up. So now this is the walkthrough of the project. So as you know that from the main page, what you can do is click on the new project, and then when you click on the new project, this the image which is shown on this slide, you will land here on this web page. You have to turn on the browse mode so that you can type in the website you want to scrap, and then click on the down arrow in order to run that website. Once that website is loaded into Parsub's interface, you can turn off the browse mode, and it will automatically switch to select mode, as you can see on the right top corner of the image. Now, how will you proceed further? Because in my case, I wanted to extract the product name. So what you can do is on the select page, if you can see the select page on the left hand side, there is a plus button. When you click on this plus button, you will get something like this. From the black menu, you can see that there is select, relative select, and click. You have to select the first option. It will give you the next tile, which is known as empty selection, as you can see on the left hand side. You can rename that tile to product name, and after renaming it, what you can do is select the product name header. Just as in this image, you can see that I have selected that RCA Galileo Pro 11.5, and it will give you the overview of how it will look inside a table. So the product name followed by a product URL. So what you can do is this has only given the first product because I have only selected the first product. The others are in waiting, as you can see that they are all in yellow boxes. So to make them to make the data parser extract them as well, you just have to click on them. So it will understand that all the headers are to be extracted as a product name. So this is how you will get your product name. Now the second thing which I wanted was the price of the product. So how can we achieve that? Simply go to the select page in the plus sign, select page bar, and click on the plus sign. From there you select the relative select. As you can already see that there is written that relative price, and in parentheses 52. That is because I have already done that. So in this you can see that the header has been turned red, and from there the two arrows are coming out. These two arrows are actually telling the parser that heading has a relation with these two. That is the price. So what Parsub understands is that this product has a price which has to be filled in the corresponding cells. So once you set that, you can click on it, and it will just select all the headers and will follow the same trend entirely. Now in the third column, which I wanted was the reviews, that is the number after the stars. To achieve that, you can again follow the same step, go to the plus sign and click on relative select. From the relative select, as you can see that a new tile will appear, relative reviews. I have renamed it as reviews, but it will be written as relative selection. So you can always rename that. In this you again have to click on the header and direct this arrow to that number which you want to extract. So it will extract the reviews from the entire page, just like it has extracted price from the entire page. Now next column was delivery type. What kind of delivery, what type of delivery each product has. In this case, in this also, I followed the same procedure of clicking on the plus button and then dragging that arrow from the selected header to this free, to this to the where it is written as free. So it will make Parser understand that you want to extract the delivery type as free, and it will select that free wherever it is written. Now this is for the first page. Now if you want to move to the next page, what you can do, you can go to the plus sign on the very first tile and select the select option. From there you will get what select next. From select next there will be a plus button after the deletion button, and from that plus button you have to click on that plus button and select click and select the and select the next arrow where it is marked as green. After that, after you select that, you will get click each next item and go to main template. That is, once it has extracted the entire product price, reviews and delivery type from the first page, it will move on to this very button and click it, so that it migrates to the next page and repeat the entire procedure. So it will keep on doing this until the pages are exhausted. So this is how you will set your workflow, and this is how you will get your data. Now, but how to get the data? It is very, very simple. You just have to click on the get data button, and once you click on the get data button, what the next window which will appear will ask you whether you want to test run it first, or you want to run it, or you want to do a final run. So it is always recommended that you do a test run first to actually see how your workflow, how your flow is working, so that you can correct it in time. And if you are sure that your workflow is correct, then you can always go for the final run. And once you click the final run, it will start scraping those pages, and in 10 to 15 minutes, or depending upon the number, the information available on the page, you will have by the end of scraping, you will have an option of downloading that data in Excel file or in JSON file or in API format. So this is the entire walkthrough of the project, of how you can extract the products and their relevant information from e-commerce website. So with this, I'm signing off. Thank you for listening to me, and if you like this video, then subscribe it. And if you want another video like these, then you can always write your comment in the comment section. Thank you. Signing off, this is RK from Parsec Research.